Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this beautiful morning. Indeed, what a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus. We are today alive just to glorify you, Jesus, and to give you honor. Bless the word and bless our brothers and sisters who are watching and who will listen later in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Wow, I greet you this morning and I say good morning, praise the Lord, how are you? And Bwana Yesu asifiwe, I know you are blessed this morning to be alive and we thank God for everything. Just have your few minutes before you go out this morning so that we can listen to what the Spirit of God is saying through His Word. And today I'm just going to talk to you about God can never forget you. Amen. And God will not forget you. He will not forget me. So we see through the prophet Isaiah, God makes a tremendously comforting promise. You may feel completely forgotten by every human being in life, but God will not forget you. Even if my father or your father and father may abandon you, the Lord will hold you close. Amen. As we see that in Psalms 27:10. But today I want to read with you from the book of Isaiah, chapter 49, verse 15 and 16. It says, can a woman forget her nursing child and not have compassion on the son of her womb? Surely they may forget, yet I will not forget you. See, I have inscribed you on the palms of my hands. Your words are continually before me. And those are the word of God he was speaking through his prophet and through his servant Isaiah. And he said, can a woman forget a son he has born? Most of time we know the love of the mother. We know how the child feels so comforted in the arms of the mother. Can sleep well, can be comforted because he or she trusts on the love of the mother. The same way, God puts this in our way. A mother may forget. Yes, it's a human being. But he assures us, surely they may forget, but I will not forget you nor forsake you. This is a comforting word this morning as you wake up and you go out. Remember, whichever you find on the way, whichever you see, whatever you hear, remember, the Lord is telling you in your ears, I will not forget you. I will not forsake you. The promises of God are yeah and amen, brothers, as we know. Whatever he has said, the Bible says in the book of Numbers that I'm not a man that I should lie, or a son of man that I should repent. So whatever God has said in his word, it is true. So let's see a mother's love. A mother's love is often considered as strongest and finest in existence. But God's love transits even the best this we can get in the world. The world may hover that care. The world may hover whatever you want. But I want to assure you that the love of God, it surpasses all the love and the care you can get from the world. So we are rest comforted this morning and assured that the Lord, we have a maker, we have a father who knows our names even before we were born. He knows when we were coming to this world. And he say, you will never never forget us. Isn't that amazing to know that there is the creator of heaven and earth is assuring us this morning that you never forget us. Don't bother and don't worry about what is going on around you. Don't worry about what you hear from the outside. Don't worry what is happening in your family. Let us be assured that the Lord has not forgotten my sister, my brother. He is still on the throne watching you and saying, I am here for you. So let's see the next verse in verse 16. In verse 16, it also gives us assurance and it says, I have engraved you on the palms of my hand. God longs to be our main source of everything we plan. Can you check this word engrave? Engrave is just putting something permanent. Your name has been written permanent in the palm of God the Father. And if he has written the name in his palms, it means that nothing can snatch you or nothing can take the love of God from you. He has already loved you and engraved you. We thank God because of his promises. I want you to take you, because I don't want to take you much time, to the prodigal son. Everybody knows the story of the prodigal son. The way he came, took whatever he took from the father, and then he went away to far country, squandered everything. And then we see the story when we read it in Luke chapter 11, verse 32. This son went away, and he took everything that he had from the father. But when you look back at home, you see the father was still looking on the way and wondering, where could my son be? What is happening with my son? Let me tell you, though the son went away, but the identity of the son did not be taken away from the father. This son could, if he was called Joseph, he was still called Joseph of John. So the identity was still there with the father. The father was watching the road every day, hoping one day my son may come back. That's how God loves us. Every time he is watching over us. And we see when the son came back, he was welcomed even more than when he was going. So what am I saying? I'm saying that the Lord God will never forget you. No matter how far you go, no matter what you may do, he is still stretching forth his hand and saying, my son, I love you. And this morning I want to assure you, my brothers and my sisters, the Lord God loves you so much. Don't just sit down and worry of the life. Don't sit down and see problems. Don't sit down and say, oh, I'm finished. No, the Lord loves you and he's embracing you this morning. So as you go out, be encouraged, be cheered up, have hope. The joy of the Lord be your strength. Wherever you go, may you be covered by that assurance that there is God in heaven, my Father, who loves me. May the Lord bless you and keep you strong. So I just want to pray with you as you go out. And Father, I thank you. Your word is so assuring and comforting that we have a Father who never leave us nor forsake us. Our mothers may forsake us. Our fathers may leave us. The family friends may go. But God, you never go. You are always on the throne. You are stretching forth your hands to embrace us when we go out and when we come in. As you say in Psalms 139, that you knows when we sit down and when we wake up. You knows when we sleep and when we wake up. You knows when we go out and when we come out. You perceive our thoughts when we are far off. So Lord, we thank you for this morning, for this brother, for this sister, for this young man who is going out today. Lord, I pray for coverage. I pray for the assurance of the word of God in their hearts. In Jesus' name, we do pray and we say, amen. God bless you. Shalom.